to Meryl's Music Room. Today is Friday, and we are going to be making our Popsicle stick harmonicas. Ah! One of my favorite make-yourself instruments. It's super, super fun. So if you don't already have your materials ready, these are the ones that you will need. You will need two Popsicle sticks, preferably the thick ones if you can get them. You will need three rubber bands, preferably two small ones, one wide one, and then some type of material to use as your separator. I'm going to be using a disposable straw. I think it's the easiest material to work with if you do not have a disposable straw. Something kind of like it will work if you have a piece of cardboard. That will work if you have a piece of, like a toothpick. That will work as well. I just found that the straws are the easiest thing to use. Now, if you need, you also need a new pair of scissors. If you don't have that, go ahead and get those. If you need to grab any of your materials, go ahead and grab, pause the video now and go grab them, and then we'll go through the assembly together. Alright, so the first thing you need to do to assemble your Popsicle stick harmonicas, you need to take your thick rubber band, and you need to stretch it along one of your Popsicle sticks so it's laying flat, and I'll get it a little bit closer to the camera so you guys can see how I did that. And then what you want to do is take your separating piece. So like I said, I'm using my straw, and you want to just cut two pieces that are a little bit wider than the Popsicle stick. So kind of like that. You can see. And then you're going to take one of those pieces, and you're going to put it under the rubber band. So it's sitting kind of like that. And then the next step, which I think is the easiest way to do this, is to actually take your second Popsicle stick, you're going to set it on top, sandwiching that little piece of straw or connector piece, whatever it is you're using, and then take your small rubber band and just tighten it around. My younger students, you may want to have your parents help you with this part. Okay. So you should have something that's kind of like this to start off with. Okay, kind of flappy here in the middle because you haven't finished that part. And then you're going to take your second piece of straw or whatever it is you're using as your connector piece, and you're going to just set it in there so it is on top of the rubber band. So the first piece went under the rubber band. This piece is going on top of the wide rubber band. And that is because we want the rubber band to be suspended inside our Popsicle stick. And if you put them both underneath the rubber band, it won't be suspended. It'll just be sitting out and it won't work correctly. And then you're gonna take your last rubber band. You're just gonna tighten it like that. So it kind of looks like almost like a skateboard kind of thing, and if you look on the inside, there is a small slit you can see through. Now, to play this instrument, you're going to set it so that just the edge of it is in your mouth, kind of use your dummy grammar like you did last week, and then all you have to do is blow. And the way it works is the rubber band is sitting at an angle on the inside of this gap. When you blow air through it, it causes that rubber band to vibrates. And remember, we said whenever it vibrates, it makes a sound. And that sound gets amplified with the wood. It helps to resonate it. So you'll actually feel the vibrations in your lips when you do this, which is kind of cool. And those vibrations are what makes their sound. What I have found is the wider the rubber band is that you use as your center rubber band, the lower the sound is. So for example, my example one that I made for you guys earlier this week has a wider rubber band, so it's lower. Whereas this one's a slightly thinner rubber band because I couldn't find two big wide ones. You can tell the difference in the sounds. I have also found that if you can adjust how hard and how soft you are blowing, that will change the sound. So try that out. You can really get some different sounds just by blowing hard and blowing slowly, or using your cold air versus your fast air, for those of you guys who have done recorder with me. And then I've also found you can change the pitch just a little bit by just kind of clamping down a little bit on it. And all I'm doing is just going. not quite that exaggerated, but just so you can see what's happened. And just so you guys can see how much I'm putting in my mouth, I'm going to do it like this. And it's just a really simple little instrument. Other people call it, we call it a harmonica because it kind of sounds like a harmonica, even though it doesn't have all the different types of notes. So that is your Popsicle Stick harmonica. On the Google Classroom, I'm also going to be linking an instructional guide that I used a few years back for a sub plan. Some of you guys, I know I've made these before with me, but we're constructing them just a little differently this time. So if you would rather use the paper copy, that is fine. Go for it. It has pictures and step-by-step instructions. That I think in that method, I used pieces of cardboard as the separating pieces. So if you don't have the straw and you're using something like cardboard and you want to see how that works, about how long, how big your cardboard needs to be, you can use that too as an example. So just check the Google Classroom if you're going to be using that particular method. Well, thank you guys so much. I will see you next week.